Have you ever heard of a voodoo doll?
Yes, I have.
I want to try something with you. It's not a voodoo doll. It's actually a corn doll. This is like one of my favorite bands, Corn. So they did this version of a doll, but I believe that you don't actually need a voodoo doll. That if you believe, you can actually use anything. But what I need to make this pertain to you is I need something from you, with your hair, if you have a ring on, a bracelet, mm-hmm. Have a ring, perfect. What I want you to do is take the ring, I want you to place it right on there, just like that.
Okay.
Now what I want you to do is I want you to turn your back to me right now. If you feel something, I want you to let me know.
My hand feels a little warm. Oh my god, that is crazy. How did you do that? I'm gonna feel something in my left leg.
What are you feeling?
It feels really hot. Oh, stop it.
Man,
you felt it?
Yeah. Ow.
Oh my god, this is so weird. How did you do that?
So check it out now. I know that you're pretty pissed off at me. So this is an opportunity to get back to me. What I want you to do is to take the doll I just gave you, take the pin I just gave you, turn you back to me, and I want you to poke the doll wherever you'd like, alright?
Where did you poke it?
In the right hand.
I'm sorry, man. Wow.
Maybe be more careful about burning people.
To bleed. That doll freaks me out. Oh my gosh, that is trippy.
I'm gonna show you something involving this, which is a doll. But the thing about this doll is that it doesn't, as it is, it doesn't have a soul. So we need to give it a soul for this to work. And that's what I'm going to do now by taking this. You happy if I use your ring for a second?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Excellent. Just allow that to sort of go floppy down there. That's great. Thank you. And the ring goes into the center here. And this makes it a soul for the doll. Just like that. Now it has a soul, and your soul, if you like. Stay there for a second for me. See, I just think it's interesting for me that we tend to believe what makes us feel good. If we decide that something is nice or makes us feel nice, that we decide that it's true. Which, you know, you could argue devalues the idea of truth terribly. Can you feel anything at the moment? What are you aware of?
My legs feel really heavy.
Can you move them? Can you move your feet? No?
I'm trying.
Yeah, okay. You can't move them. You can move your arms, yes?
Yeah.
Just flap your arms a bit for me. Just do that. Thank you. Just so you can see you can move them for a moment. And then watch. Now. Can you move your arms?
No.
You trying?
Yeah.
Okay, now look at me. This will be perfectly comfortable, all right? There's nothing unpleasant about this, perfectly comfortable. I want you to count. Just try and count all the way backwards from 10 to 0 for me, out loud.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4,
but they're close. Can you talk? See, for me, it's all about questioning, I think, and not taking things at face value. Like, at the moment, you can't speak, but the only reason why you can't speak is that you believe that you can't speak because of what I'm telling you. And the interesting thing is that if I tell you you can speak, all that does is give you permission to question that belief, and then you find that you can speak. Can't you? Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. Because what we believe isn't necessarily real at any level. I mean, this certainly isn't, it's not even a real voodoo doll. You know, and even the real voodoo dolls we used for healing, not for putting curses on people. But what I did, I got you to invest in that belief, and one of the ways I got you to do that was by investing something of yourself in it, like your ring. Whereas in fact, there's nothing in there. There is no ring in there. I didn't put your ring in there. You know, your ring's still on your hand. Yeah?
I love
it. You alright?